And welcome back again. Today we are above average across the area. Those southerly winds helped really warm us up. Unfortunately, though, it brought with it quite a bit of moisture. I told you yesterday that we could have, well, right around an inch or so of precipitation, but that could move east or west depending on where that moisture comes back. And look at that. We received just under 3 inches. So, yeah, it kind of shifted a little bit west. I was a little bit too far east with it, and I'll admit that. But today, overall, not too bad. 67 for a high, 55 for a low. Besides the rain, it was a nice day. That rain, though, thankfully, is moving on off to the east. The heaviest precipitation has gone off into Alabama. They actually had a tornado warning there a couple hours ago. Getting a zooming on closer look. Yeah, this will be out of our area pretty quickly behind it. Yeah, just some cloudy conditions, but cold conditions. That cold front's going to be sweeping on through throughout the overnight hours. And it's going to be getting a little chilly. And we have had a flood warning and a flash flood warning. This is since this actually used to be expanded back down to the southeast of Hattiesburg. As the rain's moving on off to the east, it's finally been able to diminish in size. Still, it's going to be cold. And we're going to get the rain out of here, maybe a few scattered showers. But look at this, 24-hour temperature change. You can see where the cold front is. Jackson, Macomb, and Baton Rouge are anywhere from 20 to 25 degrees below what they were last night at this time. So, yeah, that's going to be moving our way, and it's not too far from us. So we're going to be hopefully staying above freezing tonight, 33 rain and drizzle early. Those winds shifting out of the northwest, 5 to 10 miles per hour. And then once those showers get on through, again, we'll clear out for tomorrow. We might have a few clouds, but we're going to see some sun, thankfully. So we'll get this rain out of here. It's really a 24-hour ordeal. Then we're looking at some nice conditions besides some cooler temperatures. So we'll be in the lower 50s. Those winds out of the northwest, 5 to 10 miles per hour. Brilliant. It's going to be nice. Sunshine. Just make sure you got to take a jacket with you because we're going to be drier and cool across the southeastern U.S. And we're going to have to get used to these cool conditions because we're going to have them later this week into next week, really. We're talking several shots of this. The core of the cold staying on up to our north. But yet again, we'll be below average, as you saw on our climate map yesterday and really all this week that I've shown it to you. So your weather is brought to you by Richard Schwartz and Associates. Thursday, again, sunshine for tomorrow. Overnight lows, we're going to be dipping below freezing. Then Friday, we're only going to get in the lower 50s. Some of us are going to be hard stuck to get into the 50s, especially up north. Probably going to be in the upper 40s. Mostly sunny conditions over overnight lows. Yeah, mid-20s, we're talking wind chills in the lower 20s. And then for your weekend, we might have a few clouds on your Saturday, but still, we're going to warm up. And I'm saying warm up because it's in relative terms again. Into the mid-50s, overnight lows will stay above freezing. 62 for your Monday, but then look at that. Yeah, we're going to have a cold front move through again. A couple showers possible for your Tuesday and your Wednesday. We'll slowly start to cool on down back into the 50s and the 40s for the middle part of next week. Overnight lows again, getting into the lower 20s. Some of us probably up north could be in the teens along with that. And we're looking at some very, very cold nights next week. So we'll kind of enjoy this weekend, enjoy your Monday, and then get ready, you know, keep the heavy coat out because you're going to need it going into Tuesday, Wednesday, and even Thursday at this point.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you.